So in this video, we have to see a simple, very basic login activity in Android. So the user interface would be like this. You have a login label, or then you have to type the username, and then you have to type the password. And after clicking the submit button, whether the user entered the correct information or not, a message will be displayed on the screen for a few seconds. So let me first show you how it works. So I have taken the username and password as user and password as password. Then I click submit. So it will, you will see user successfully login. And if I miss any value, user or name or password, either user is null or blank. If I miss, if I write users correctly, so this user correctly and password blank, then password is null or blank. So I have checked all the cases, whether the username and password is correct or whether it is blank or not. So let's start. If you are not aware about how to create a simple login, simple activity in the Android, then you have to see my previous video. And I'm assuming you are aware about how to create a simple activity, a simple project. So here we have a simple activity, activity main.xml file, and we have a main activity, and I have created a login activity because we have to first create this kind of layout. So for that purpose, what I do, so I'm showing also in split view or in design view. So this would be the design, but I have preferred to do it by coding. So this code up till this line is already available when you create any login, any XML file. So it will provide you constant layout. So in that layout, I have created first the relative layout. So relative layout I have created because I need the other elements in the of your layout relative to the each other, so that their position are relative to each other. So for the relative layout, the property is layout width, layout height. It should be match parent. So match parent means it is matching the size of your mobile, and then there is some margin from the left and from the right. Okay, after that I have taken a text view. So this is the text view, login. So it's, so first property is layout width, that is wrap content, and height is also wrap content. It means whatever I have right here, it will only take that much of amount of alphabets or that much amount of values. And I have created its ID login, and then I have created a string. So it is stored in a file named string.xml. So here the message.login is basically login. So if you see here, it is login. Then text size, if you want to increase the size, and then align parent top. So in respect to parent, it will on the top, and it is become layout centered horizontal, which means it is at the horizontally placed. It is placed centrally with respect to horizontal. Then we have again edit text. So edit text means we want to edit something. So for that purpose, we have a edit text. So I have taken user, its ID, username, and then same things, the content, and the value of the this string is username, is here username, and it's it is layout below. So it is below the login. So whose ID is login? It is below that component. So it is below the text view, and it is also center horizontal true, and I have taken some color and some size. Similarly, we have for password, its ID is password, its input type is text password. It means whenever you type something, it will not visible. So that's why I have type, that's why I have taken its input type equal to text password. And the other things are same. It is also layout below is between the username, below the user. And then I have taken a button. So button here, this is a button. Its size, its color, and it is also horizontal, center horizontally true, and it is below the password. Okay, and the main property is on click. On when you click on this button, it will move to the validate user. The validate user function. So let's see our activity, main activity.java. So in main activity.java, I have first changed the set content view, set content view to login. So by default, the set content view is set to the main activity underscore main.xml file. But I have created a separate XML file, and I don't want to create a new activity .java file. So that's why I'm reusing that activity dot my main activity.java file. So I'm just changing here set content view to r.layout.login, and after that I have that validate user. So I have discussed about this method here, validate user method. So after on click, the control will move to the validate user. So we have this validate user. So what I have to do, I have to, the logic is like that, whatever I have type here, when I click on submit, I have to first extract the username and the password, and then match with the hard coded username and the password. So I have taken the hard coded username and password as user and password. So because of this hard coded, and I don't want to change this, so that's why I have taken this as a private static final string. So what I do, first I take the username text and then password text. So how could I get extract these values? By using the find view by id method. So this is the username, so I have to check its id, r.id.username, r.id.password. If you see here, id password and id username, so you have to write the same thing. So then you have to cast it in edit text. So I have got the username text and password text. Then I convert that username text and password text to a string by extracting the text from that username and the password. So for that purpose, I have a function get text, and then I convert it into toString using toString method. And this is for, this line is for only debugging purpose, so that you could see what is the username and password. And after that, it is just the basic if and else loop. So I'm just checking whether the username is null and not null, and then username is not equal to blank. Then I go inside, then I check the path for the password, whether the password is not equal to null and password is not equal to blank. And then I check, it means both things are there and both are not null. Then I check whether the username equals to username, means the username that I have stored, or the username that I have get from the user, and the password. If it is match, then I show a success message, I use a toast. So for toast, you have to write toast.makeText, and then here you have to write the get application context. And then user successful login, you have to type the text message whatever you want, and toast.length long, it means it will display to some long seconds, and then you have to write the test.show. And other code is similarly the failure cases. Whenever you fail, you have to put some message, please check your credentials, or if password is null or blank, whether the user is null or blank, and every time you have to show the toast. So I'm repeating everything. I have just created the main activity, and in main activity I have created then layout. So in layout, I have added text and the button and the text view and all these things under the relative layout. And I have also created the string.xml file. So in string.xml file, we have these key value pairs. And one more thing I have to do, I have to change the I don't need to change that in Android manifest XML file, because my main activity is the same activity. So after that, you have to run this file. Let me stop again and again run this, run it. Then you have to enter something, user password, submit. So user successfully login. That's all. Thank you very much.